Hello guys, in this video I'm going to make a quick demo of Maya force and fields working with Moov Air Physics. We are going to add some air and gravity to our simulation, something like what you see in this animation. See how the hair is being pushed to the right side of the character. So open the sample scene and get ready. First thing first, I'm going to add an air field and a gravity field to the scene. You can find them in the field solvers menu. You can try the drag force, Newton, radial, turbulence or any other fields and solvers from this menu. For this short demo, I will use the air and gravity fields. As always, I'm going to turn off unnecessary operators for now. In the force fields section in the Moov Physics operator, click the Add Force Fields button and pick the gravity field object in the viewport. You will see the object being added to the list. But if I run the simulation, there is no gravity field affecting the hair yet. This is because the default gravity value in the Moov Physics operator is higher than the magnitude value of the gravity field. We have to use a comparable value to be able to see this effect. So if we go back to the gravity field and increase the magnitude value to something like 980 or higher and run the simulation, you will see the gravity field in action. You can also change the direction of the field on X, Y, or Z. Okay, that's pretty straightforward. Now let's try the airfield. Remove the gravity field by selecting it in the list and using the Remove Force Field button in the Force Field section. Or you can leave it there if you want. You can combine several fields. Then add the airfield as we did before. Now select the airfield object. We have to change some settings there. First, turn off Use Max Distance and reduce the attenuation to 0.001. This way, we don't have to worry about the distance between the airfield object and the hair object. Now we can start playing with the magnitude value and other parameters like direction. Increase the magnitude value until you see the effect of the air on the hair object and change the direction to X, Y, or Z as you desire. Okay, it's time to run the simulation and see what happens. Looks good. Keep playing with those parameters and other fields to see how far you can go. When you are done, use the animation cache operator to export the animation the same way we did in the previous tutorial. And that's it. That's all for this video. Please leave your questions in the comment sections or in our Facebook groups where you can get help from the Ornatrix community and follow the latest development news. See you guys in the next tutorial.